Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss about the water softening process. In this water softening process, there are the three methods. First one is the soda lime process, then zeolite method, and last one is the demineralization method. Now let us start with the hardness of water. First of all, what is meant by softening of water? The reduction or the removal of hardness present in a water sample is called water softening. Means whenever we remove the salts, impurity, suspended metals present in water, then we call that water is the water softening water. Now this type of hardness are divided into two types. Means hardness is divided into two subtypes. First one is the temporary hardness and second is the permanent hardness. We know that the temporary hardness is alternatively called as the carbonate or bicarbonate type of hardness. It is removed by just simply boiling method, whereas the permanent hardness is called the hardness of water in which the sulfate, chlorides, nitrates are present. Means whenever the water containing only carbonate and bicarbonate is called temporary, and whenever the water containing the sulfate, chloride, nitrate, this type of impurity, then it is called the permanent hardness. Temporary hardness is the why it is called the temporary, because just by using a boiling process the all impurities get removed, but there are some special methods are required to remove the sulfate, chloride and nitrate present in water, so that it is the permanent type of hardness. Now the methods of removal of temporary hardness. First one is the boiling process. The temporary hardness is due to the presence of calcium bicarbonate, magnesium bicarbonate, calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonate. Means all carbonate and bicarbonate type of impurities. Both calcium and magnesium bicarbonate decompose when we give the heat to that water. The original insoluble carbonate is reformed. This happens when the water is undergoes the boiling process. Now the reaction of boiling method. When the calcium bicarbonate present in a water and that water undergoes the heating process, then calcium carbonate type of PPT is formed at the bottom of that water with removal of CO2. Similarly, when the magnesium bicarbonate undergoes the heating process, then magnesium carbonate type of PPT is settled down at the bottom of the vessel and with removal of CO2. In first reaction, there is a print mistake, means there is a calcium carbonate, not a calcium LO3. Okay, then this temporary hardness is usually caused by the thermally unstable magnesium bicarbonate and calcium bicarbonate, because these are dissolved in a water and in the form of PPT. So by just the boiling, then these salts present like a carbonate and bicarbonate get settled down in the form of PPT, and that PPT get removed by just a filtration of water, so that it is called the temporary hardness of water. Now the second one is the Clark method. In this there is the addition of lime. Means first one is the addition of first one is the boiling method and second one is the addition of lime. Now the calcium hydroxide, means we know that it is the lime. In Clark is the Clark reagent. It remove the hardness of water by converting bicarbonate into a carbonate. Now let us see the reaction. When the calcium hydroxide, means a Clark's reagent, is added in a water which containing a calcium bicarbonate type of impurity, means that calcium hydroxide is directly reacted with a calcium bicarbonate, and the calcium carbonate type of PPT is settled down at the bottom of the water. So after filtration we can remove that calcium carbonate. Now when the magnesium bicarbonate type of impurity present in water, then when the Clark's reagent is added, means when the calcium hydroxide is added in a magnesium bicarbonate type of impurity present in water, then again that calcium carbonate settle down as in the form of PPT plus magnesium hydroxide type of PPT is also formed in the water. So we can remove that PPT by filtration method. This is the second method, is called the Clark's method. In this process, the precipitate out the calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxide, which can be filtered off, means which can be removed by just a filtration method. These are the methods which are used for remove the temporary hardness. One is the Clark's method and second one is the boiling process. Now the next concept is the method of removal of permanent hardness. Now there are special methods, name are soda lime process, zeolite process and demineralization process. These methods are used to remove the permanent type of hardness, means sulfate, nitrate, chlorides present in water, then this can be removed by using this process. Now let us see the first one, soda lime process. In soda lime process, this use in a water treatment to remove the hardness present in a water like nitrate, chloride, sulfates. So this process is now obsolete but was very useful for the treatment of large volume of hard water. Addition of lime, we know that the lime means the calcium dihydroxide and soda means Na2CO3. Means chemical formula for the lime is the CaOH taken twice and for the soda this is the Na2CO3 to the hard water. Precipitate, the calcium as a carbonate and magnesium as its hydroxide, means whenever we add a lime and soda to the hard water, then we form the PPT like a calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxide. The amount of two chemicals required are easily calculated from the analysis of water and stoichiochemistry of the reaction. The lime soda uses lime and Na2CO3 to precipitate hardness from the solution. In this method, we add the two chemicals, means the soda and lime in the water. We can see it in a diagram. The calcium hydroxide and carbonate hardness, means the calcium and magnesium bicarbonate, are complex by a lime. In this process, the calcium and magnesium ions are precipitated by the addition of lime like a calcium dihydroxide and soda Na2CO3. Now we can see it in a diagram. There is a diagram of a soda lime process. There is first one is the inlet. That inlet used to insert the raw water. Then again in second from the left hand side there is a one square box in which the lime plus soda is added, and there is another inlet which are used from that lime plus soda to the reaction tank. First one is the raw water, second one is the lime plus soda, and third one is the coagulants, means which is used as to coagulate that all the impurity present in that water. So we add these chemicals in a reaction tank, then there the reaction is occurred, and then again it undergo the filtration method, so that whenever it undergo the filtration, then all the impurity in the presence of carbonate and bicarbonate get removed and water get converted into a soft water. Now the following reactions are occurred, or following reactions are happened in this process. First one is when the slack lime is added to the water, it will react with any carbon dioxide present in as follows. When the CaOH taken twice plus CO2, it gives the CaCO3 in the form of PPT plus water. The lime will react with carbonate hardness as follows. Now this lime, whenever react with a calcium bicarbonate, then again the calcium carbonate type of PPT is settled down in a water. Simultaneously, when that lime is added with a magnesium bicarbonate type of impurity present in a water, then again magnesium carbonate type of PPT is settled down with calcium carbonate type of PPT in a water. After filtration, we get to remove that PPT present in water, and water get converted into a soft water. Now the product magnesium carbonate is in equation 3 is soluble. To the remove it, more lime is added. Means whenever there is a formation of product in a reaction is the magnesium carbonate, but it is again easily soluble in a water. So we can add the more lime to remove that magnesium carbonate. Means whenever that magnesium carbonate is not form a PPT or it is remain in a water, then again the maximum lime is added in that water, so that the calcium hydroxide means lime is added in a magnesium carbonate type of water impurity. Then again that lime is reacted with a magnesium carbonate and gives the calcium carbonate type of PPT settled down with removal of magnesium hydroxide of PPT. So by using the maximum amount of lime, we can remove the magnesium carbonate type of impurity present in a water. So the magnesium, also the magnesium non-carbonate hardness such as magnesium sulfate is also removed. Means whenever the lime is reacted with water which containing a hardness like a magnesium sulfate, then the calcium sulfate with magnesium hydroxide type of PPT get removed from the water. Now when the lime is added, they remove only magnesium hardness and calcium carbonate hardness. We can see it in equation 5 that the magnesium is precipitated. However, an equivalent amount of calcium is added. The water now contains the original calcium non-carbonate hardness and calcium non-carbonate hardness produced in equation 5 or the reaction 5. Now the soda, whenever means the Na2CO3, whenever added in a water which containing a calcium sulfate type of impurity, then the sodium sulfate get removed with forming the PPT calcium carbonate in water. So whenever the soda means Na2CO3 react with a calcium sulfate, then it gives sodium sulfate with removal of calcium carbonate PPT. The precipitate of CaCO3 means calcium carbonate requires a pH about 9.5, so that PPT of magnesium hydroxide requires a pH about 10.8. Therefore, the excess of lime is added to raise the pH of that water, so that reaction is possible. Now, the amount of lime required is equal to lime in liter is equal to carbon dioxide in liter plus carbonate hardness in liter plus magnesium ions plus 1.25. Now, amount of soda lime is required is equal to soda lime is equal to non-carbonate hardness in liter. After softening, the water will have high pH and contain the excess of lime and the magnesium hydroxide and the calcium carbonate that did not precipitate. Recarbonization means again addition of carbon dioxide. It used to stabilize the water. The excess lime and magnesium hydroxide are stabilized by adding carbon dioxide with which require the pH 10.8 to 9.5, so that the CO2 plus calcium hydroxide gives the CaCO3 in the form of PPT in a water. Now whenever that CO2 is again reacted with a magnesium hydroxide present in water, then it again forming a magnesium carbonate. But we know that magnesium carbonate is easily dissolved in a water. So again the maximum type of lime is added in water to remove the magnesium carbonate type of impurity. For this reaction, again the pH will maintain about the 8.5. So to stabilize that, the calcium carbonate is removed. Now, then again, when the CO2 react with the calcium carbonate in the presence of water, then it gives the calcium bicarbonate. But it is not possible to remove all the hardness from the water, so that the actually about 50 to 80 milligram per liter will remain as the residual hardness. Then the limitations of soda lime process. Soda lime process is used for the water softening that cannot produce a water at completely free of hardness because of solubility, that the little of calcium carbonate and magnesium hydroxide. Thus, the minimum calcium hardness can be achieved. It about the 30 milligram per liter as calcium carbonate, and the magnesium hardness is about 10 milligram per liter as calcium carbonate. Second is to normally tolerate the final total hardness on water of 75 to 120 milligram per liter as calcium carbonate. But the magnesium content should not exceed 40 milligram per liter as calcium carbonate, because a greater hardness of magnesium forms a scale on heat exchange element. Now let us discuss second method, zeolite process. The zeolite method is the method in which the micropores, three-dimensional crystalline solid of aluminium silicate, zeolite, which is also called the zeolite, have a small openings of a fixed size is then, which allow the small molecules to pass through then the easily, but the larger molecule cannot pass through them. This is why they are sometimes called the molecular sieves. We know that the molecular sieves are the small type of pores, having a small types of pores, so that the large molecules cannot penetrate from this one. So small molecules only pass out this one. Whenever there are the suspended or remaining type of impurities, they can captured by that molecular sieves and exchange. Means in a zeolite process, we know that the zeolite means sodium zeolite is used for this water softening process. The hard water is percolate at the specified rate through a bed of zeolite. Now this zeolite holds the sodium ion loosely and can be replaced by sodium zeolite. That sodium zeolite represent by a Na2Z or Na2ZE. When the water pass through the sodium zeolite bed, the hardness causing ions like a calcium, magnesium, etc. are captured by a zeolite, and they can exchange with a calcium, means all the impurities are captured by a zeolite bed, and zeolite get exchanged with a or react with a calcium, and the calcium zeolite and magnesium zeolite are formed. While the outgoing water containing equivalent amount of sodium salts. Now the reactions are, when the calcium bicarbonate reacts with a sodium zeolite, then the calcium zeolites are formed with removal of sodium bicarbonate. In second reaction, when the magnesium bicarbonate type of impurity is present in a water, then sodium zeolite are again reacted with magnesium bicarbonate, then removal of magnesium zeolite, means the salts are captured by a zeolite bed with the removal of sodium bicarbonate. Then all these reactions are happened with a sodium zeolite like a CaSO4, then calcium dichloride, magnesium sulfate, magnesium chloride, means the temporary hardness and permanent hardness both are get removed by zeolite method. After some time, when the zeolite is completely changed, then this is called the exhausted zeolite. Exhausted means a capacity of exchanging ions with hardness salts get over, so that it is called the exhausted zeolite. Then in this case, so it can be regenerated So means zeolites are again regenerated by using a 10% of brine, means a 10% solution of sodium chloride. Means whenever the calcium zeolite reacted with the sodium chloride, then again regeneration of sodium zeolite is occurred. Now the advantage and disadvantage of the zeolite process. Advantage: it removes the hardness almost completely, means about 10 ppm hardness only. The process is automatically adjust itself from variation in hardness of incoming water. This process does not involve any type of precipitation, thus no problem of sludge formation is occurred. Now disadvantage: the outgoing water contain more sodium salts. Second, this method is only replace calcium and magnesium type of ions by sodium ions. And third one is the highly turbidity water cannot be softened efficiently by zeolite process. Hope so you understand all the concept. This is the diagram of zeolite method, in which we can see that whenever the hard water is inserted on the zeolite bed, then there is the exchange of calcium and magnesium ions present in a water sample with the sodium zeolite. Then equivalent amount of sodium ions are get replaced or get exchanged with salts present in the water, and equivalent amount of sodium released in the water with capturing all the cations present in water. Then whenever the capacity of that zeolite bed is over, then 10% of brine is added, means the 10% of NaCl solution is added, so that whenever we sprinkle that 10% of NaCl solution, then zeolite bed is can be get reclaimed or regained. So at the bottom we can see in a diagram that the soft water is collected from the outlet. This is the overall diagram of zeolite bed or the zeolite process. Hope so you understand all the methods of water softening process. Thank you.